You're all going into battle.
I mean,
most of you won't make it out alive.
That was,
some of you will make it out alive, but you'll be missing out on
the Disney Witch movie.
I myself will be sitting in a very comfortable chair.
The one with the fat witch?
Watching this all go
down.
She has
a fat personality. Like, yeah. You could just hear her like she's...
America!
Everybody, this is Excalibur trying to pull the sword from the stone. Is the battery dead? Hey buddy, I know it's not really a good time right now.
I told you I'm Excalibur! Sure, you think you know what happened, Matt, but really we all know just because I touched it.
Bow, bow, bow. Bow, bow, bow.
Bow, bow, bow.
That looks so disgusting.
Man,
that is an interesting face.
Man, you guys have no manners.
Everybody needs manners.
I've apparently never been to Italian.
Wait.
Thank you.
Hey, camera, let me show you something about manners that Brian loves. This is what Brian does when he goes to dinner.
I can't even, there it is! That's Matt's best friend. This is Matt. Matt's best friend. Matt. Matt's best friend. Matt. Matt's best friend. Matt. I see you go.
That.
What's the other one you know?
I don't know the words, but it's the... That if you wanna go and take a ride with me, if you wanna go and take a ride with me,
life right here.
Yeah, I'm Leo.
Gilberto.
Hey, nice to meet you, man.
This is Alex.
Hi, I'm Alex. Nice to meet you. We're gonna...
Yeah,
let's look around.
This room.
Oh, rad.
And
Yeah, if you want to set up like a merch over there.
Oh. Yeah, yeah.
You can put your stuff in this room.
I like the padding on the walls. That's some good padding.
Very nice.
We can just like put our gear in here?
Yeah, just in
this. This is the most interesting spot I've ever seen.
Yes, the most interesting spot.
Ever. Which drawing, Leo?
I'm drawing Alex, which is you.
Oh my god, this is awesome. I like how I'm so jolly.
You're such a jolly dude,
bro.
He's got his
own
effect.
Picks that awesome
drawing. Oh, why is so fucking self-centered right now?
Hey,
I thought you were gonna draw.
That's a nose? My nose look.
Wait, did you
get it?
Fucking way up! Alex!
Buddy. Straight edge.
Buddy. What's the most important thing in life?
Straight edge.
Explain to me how the show was.
It was very small.
Very small room.
Very small room. Awesome. With a lot of people in it. Brian freaked out at the end. We thought he was crying because he broke his bass.
I thought I was crying?
So we felt bad. But then he gets up and he goes, oh, it's not broken.
That's not exactly how it happened.
That's not what happened at all. No. What the fuck?
Leo's sometimes a tall tailor.
A little bit.
Tall tailor.
So what happened is Jesus Christ came down from the heavens and picked me up. And as I ascended, he realized that he can't take me through the ceiling like he can because he's in ethereal form. I'm just a human being. So I hit the ceiling and I fell down on my base. And when I landed on my base, it shattered into 30 equal-sized pieces. And so what I had to do was, before the song was over, gather up each of those equal-sized pieces and bring them to the forge
and put at
in Mount Doom of Mordor, and I had to go in and reforge my base.
Why would
and
you
I had
do
to
that?
Come back.
Everybody knows.
And I had to. You let me finish.
I'll let you finish, and then I'm going to present mine.
So as I was saying, I traveled to Mount Doom.
Wait, are they open
in the Land of Mordor, and I was reforging my base because I needed to come back to the show in order to complete my quest, which was to finish the song. So I got back, and when I returned, there happened to be a very large dragon who Buddy Porter had turned into in the meantime, because everybody knows that straight edge kids are actually dragons on the inside.
That's true.
So what happened was the most epic battle that any man could ever imagine happening in their life.
With a rhythm guitarist.
With a rhythm guitarist versus a bass player. And literally what we had to do was I took my bass and I rammed it so far up his butt that he was forced to scream, letting out all the fire that dragons are made of, because dragons are made of fire, it's a little known fact. And so when he spit out all the fire, he sort of shrunk back down into Buddy Porter, at which point I was able to kick him square in the testicles, and he cried like a little baby, and then we were able to finish the song. So everything worked out okay in the long run. It really wasn't a big deal.
And when you say we were able to finish the song, you mean me, Matt, Alex, and Leo, right?
And when you say he cried like a little baby, you mean a big boy.
Yes. I mean a big boy.
My name is Alex. I'm the drummer for Plagues. I'm here with Buddy. Buddy Porter. Buddy, what is the top three things in your life?
Straight edge, XXX, drug free.
Who's your favorite Plagues member?
Ooh. Okay, this might seem a little biased because you're doing the interview, but definitely Brian.
Now, do you have some mixed feelings about Brian?
I really do. Here's the thing. I think he's really cool, but then he tries to act like my dad. And fuck that, you know? I kind of, like, if Brian and Matt, like, I don't know if you ever watched Dragon Ball Z, but they have, like, these fusion earrings. So if Matt and Brian did the fusion dance and fused, I think I would like that much better than Brian. Because Matt's like the easygoing, like, we can hang out and it'll be cool no matter what kind of guy. But Brian's like, if you don't do your statistics homework, then you're fucked kind of guy.
You're not gonna get a dagger? Right there?
Oh, I guess I am, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Trio?
Somewhere right there.
You should be able to.
Yeah, we should be able to.
This is Buddy's aftermath. Bloody.
Looks good, dude. Bloody Buddy.
Okay, you wanna
so, Brian, explain to me. What just happened a moment ago?
We were gonna go get Buddy from the tattoo shop because they didn't know where the van was.
This is Buddy, and just so you know.
And
you'll see us.
I proceeded to exit the van, and I opened the door, and my foot happened to be caught on the strap of this camera, and so I fell flat on my fucking face right out of the door, and two gentlemen happened to be walking by, saw the door open, and then a guy just come tumbling out of the van onto the pavement. So that was cool because it hurts really bad on my arm right now, but yeah.
You want a molly, bro?
Hell yes. Tell me a joke.
I don't know jokes. There was this guy, his name was Brian, he fell out of the car and he went on his face. That was not really a joke, but it was pretty funny.